Yasty, Tay-Tay, Yasty, 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 Yas. I'm mega confident that pop megastar Taylor Swift has released one of the greatest masterpieces of the 21st century, no doubt. Hello, everyone. How are you? Welcome to another segment of Biased, the video series where I talk about things that I enjoy for your enjoyment. I'm your host, your favorite man child, Super Jesus Jackson. Today, we will be talking about Taylor Swift's lover. Okay, not like the person that she's been with for the last 3 years. I mean her song, Lover. Taylor Swift's Lover, released as the third single off of her 2019 album Lover on August 16th, 2020, is a soft pop, country-ish indie folk song. I don't know. Some people say that it's like indie folk. I would disagree. I think it's a lot more poppy, but I mean, hey. It was one of the bigger hits off of her album, although I think me, probably, me, capital letters, M-E, exclamation point, I think probably did commercially probably a lot better. I hear that a lot more on the radio than Lover. But nevertheless, I think it did pretty well for her. It was the leading single to the album's release, and I think it's a masterpiece, and we're going to talk about it right here. Let's begin. Now, disclaimer, I am a guy, so me telling you that I really like this song, I think, says a lot. I mean, you know, like, I just think that this song is like, you know, The Notebook, like, in song form. So this song has a lot of flair, specifically with the production and the instrumentation, but the reverb that is on this song is just perfect. It just sounds like it's recorded, like, in an empty venue, you know, just Taylor and her band, and that's it, no one else. It adds, I think, to the intimacy of the track.
The bass
is very pronounced in this song, and it has a very warm groove to it. Taylor's vocal melody and the verses are phenomenal, too.
We could leave the Christmas lights up till January. This is our place. We made the rules.
If you think her melodies are great in the verses, just you wait until you get to the chorus of the song. Simply put, it's one of the greatest choruses I've ever heard in my entire life. Just the, can I go where you go? Can we always be this close? Take me out, take me home. The lyrics and the melody, so lovely.
Can I go where you go? Can we always be this close? Forever and ever and on. Take me out and take me home.
It's humble, vulnerable, and romantically powerful. The bridge of this track, which, I mean, let's take a moment to, you know, do a round of applause for this song for actually having a bridge. And, I mean, Taylor herself is very proud of this bridge. She said it herself in an interview with Vogue. I think this bridge is great because it's just the way she sings and the instrumentation. These plucks, which I don't even know what they are, but they're great.
Ladies and gentlemen.
The bass and the drum groove.
Lover, and you'll say all your dirtiest jokes on me. And at every table.
Now, don't get me wrong, the melody in the bridge is great. But I specifically think that it's the way that she sings it that really brings it home. And I think it's because the whole song has this consistent, really breathy vocal expression. And it just ends up melting your heart.
I'll save you a seat.
See, I'm a guy, so for me, hearing a girl just sing in this really kind of sexy way, you know, sweet, vulnerable way, but at the same time having enough grit and vocal fry in her voice is just great. Like, I would die if I ever had a girl sing this song to me in this way. I mean, I would die in general if a girl sang this song to me, but... And you can hear this breathy expression to her voice in the entire song, more so in the chorus and the bridge, of course. I think songs written by females are very special. Now, obviously, I am a little biased, 'cause I'm a guy, but if you take a listen to other artists like Best Coast, for example, who write really good songs, really romantic, sentimental songs, you'll see what I mean. Let me explain. So it's kind of a given, obviously, because women in general tend to have higher vocal registers compared to men. But I do think that the songwriting can also get affected. And so in turn, you have a song that is a little more warm, more sentimental than a song that a guy could write. Now, that's not to say that women don't have range, because they do. You can listen to some other songs that Taylor Swift has where her voice, she goes pretty low. I just think that the songwriting can potentially be more warm, more sentimental, just in an easier way when it's written by a female. And I think that has to do with the natural vocal register of a woman, and also, I guess, in particular women, whenever they try to go into and express their notebook part of their psyche. For the love of God, please don't cancel me. Now, we all know Taylor is a great lyricist, and this song is absolutely no exception. We could leave the Christmas lights up till January. This is our place, we made the rules. And there's a dazzling haze, a mysterious way about you, dear. Have I known you 20 seconds? 20 years. Okay, honey, first of all, if you're Mexican, you're already leaving your Christmas lights up until January because of the Three Wise Men holiday that we celebrate. So, nothing special there. But overall, I mean, it's a very cute verse there. It just really shows the intimacy and comfort you can have with someone that you love. We could let our friends crash in the living room. This is our place, we make the call. And I'm highly suspicious that everyone who sees you wants you. Damn, everyone? Like, even your friends want to get with your lover? Maybe you should get some new friends, Taylor. I kid. Lover. Ladies and gentlemen. Okay, bars. What I get from this is, it's her just saying, you see all this pain that I've been through? Yeah, I don't care, because it's what led me here, and I love this man. And also, whatever pain in the future that I have to go through with this man, I don't care either, because I love him. I love it. Bars. Here we have two people that have finally achieved happiness through all their struggle. You'll say all your dirtiest jokes on me. I love how this line is both sexy and romantic. The way she sings it, of course, is that way too. You're killing me, Taylor. You're killing me. You're killing me, Taylor. God. Cunt, stop. Stop. That's it. She killed me. I can't talk about this song anymore. I just can't. She killed me. I'm dead. I'm gone.
A murderer, you say? I do declare.
And that is why, guys, Taylor Swift's Lover is a masterpiece. That is why Taylor Swift's Lover is so good. And I mean, he must be pretty damn good. I mean, if he inspired her to write a song like this. Well, there it is, guys. I hope you enjoyed this one. This was your host, your favorite man child, Super Jesus Jackson. Check out my previous video where we talked about Radiohead's groundbreaking Kid A album, which just did so much for me. Follow my social medias and listen to my original music. The links are down below. Subscribe, share, like, comment if you enjoyed. And if you didn't enjoy the video, go ahead and dislike it. Most importantly, though, I value your viewership. I appreciate that you're here. Until next time, guys. I love you. My hair be looking a little spiffy today. My hair be looking a little spiffy today, isn't it? It's a little spiffy today.